It is the 26th season of the Premier League. Behind us, 25 years of drama, goals and glory.
On he goes! Oh! Breathtakingly brilliant.
Arnold Di Canio, what a magnificent goal by the Italian. Henry.
Antonio Conte voiced concerns that Chelsea's summer recruitment was insufficient. The £58 million arrival of Real Madrid striker Alvaro Morata fueled speculation of a departure for Diego Costa, while the champions also signed Timoe Bakayoko and Antonio Rudiger. Some big spending at Manchester City, Edison, Benjamin Mendy, Kyle Walker and Danilo all came in to bolster their defence, while the addition of midfielder Bernardo Silva took Pep Guardiola's outlay beyond £200 million. 4 years since Manchester United's last Premier League title, Jose Mourinho brought in Romelu Lukaku for an initial £75 million, with Nemanja Matic and Victor Lindelof also arriving. After Liverpool's first top four finish in three seasons, Jurgen Klopp hoped to kick on with new signings Mohamed Salah and Andy Robertson. Having signed a two-year contract extension, Arsene Wenger marked his 22nd season as Arsenal boss with the signings of Alexander Lacazette and Saïd Kolasinac. Having bid farewell to White Hart Lane, Tottenham moved to Wembley with their new home under construction. No pre-season signings, though, for Spurs. Big money purchases Michael Keane and Jordan Pickford arrived at Everton, while Wayne Rooney returned to his boyhood club. West Ham added summer transfers Marco Arnautovic, Javier Hernandez, Joe Hart and Pablo Zabaleta. Despite relegation with Hull City, Marco Silva returned to Premier League management at Watford. Southampton replaced Claude Puel with Maurizio Pellegrino, while Crystal Palace welcomed former Ajax manager Frank de Boer. Rafael Benitez guided Newcastle United to promotion from the Championship. Huddersfield Town anticipated their first season in the Premier League. And Brighton and Hove Albion returned to the top flight for the first time since 1983. The cast had assembled. The Premier League was back.
Friday evening at the Emirates, quite a setting to kick off the season. Arsenal hosted Leicester City, the fairy tale champions from 2 years before.
Two of the golden threads in the Premier League tapestry entwined on opening night.
A frenetic opening saw both sides trade the lead. Lacazette registering a debut goal before Leicester hit back through Shinji Okazaki and Jamie Vardy. After Vardy put the Foxes 3-2 up in the second half, substitutes Aaron Ramsey and Olivier Giroud stole the show.
Aimed in beyond Walcott, Ramsey! 3-3 on a thrilling opening night. Xhaka's corner, Giroud! Wow! A game of margins, a game of thrills. Drama from day one. This is the league we want to watch.
Mohamed Salah opened his account for Liverpool at Watford, but a late Miguel Britos equaliser snatched a 3-3 draw for Marco Silva's side. Wayne Rooney marked his return to Everton with a bang, the striker's goal downing Stoke 1-0 at Goodison Park. Romelu Lukaku began his Manchester United career with two strikes in a 4-0 demolition of West Ham. And a first-ever Premier League encounter for Brighton and Hove Albion saw them defeated by Pep Guardiola's Manchester City. Champions Chelsea kicked off with a visit from Burnley. Antonio Conte was keen to avoid a repeat of the club's lackluster title defence two seasons previously. But an early red card for Gary Cahill proved the catalyst for a nightmare first half. Sean Dyche's side took the Blues apart, netting three goals in front of a stunned Stamford Bridge.
Forced delivery, Burnley looking for three and finding goal number three. Sam Vokes again. Chelsea collapsing before our eyes.
Despite a spirited second-half display from the home side, including a debut goal for Alvaro Morata, Burnley held on to record a remarkable 3-2 victory. Chelsea look to atone the following week against London rivals Tottenham in Spurs' first league match at Wembley. Marcus Alonso's sublime free kick was cancelled out by a Michy Batshuayi own goal.
Chelsea have it with Pedro. Slipped in here for Alonso! Squeezed it in! Thrillingly for Chelsea! It's his day! Chelsea's day! And Mauricio Pochettino cannot believe what he has just seen.
Manchester United's impressive start continued as they defeated Swansea 4-0. Stoke stole the gloss from Arsenal's victory over Leicester, a debut goal from loan signing Hesse securing Mark Hughes a 1-0 win. Pressure was already mounting on Frank de Boer at Crystal Palace. A 2-0 defeat at home to Swansea left the Eagles without a point or goal scored in their opening three matches. And having dropped 2 points in a draw with Everton, Manchester City travelled to Bournemouth. Despite a Charlie Daniels wonder goal, Raheem Sterling's late winner sealed a 2-1 victory for City. Liverpool welcomed Arsenal to Merseyside, with Philippe Coutinho yet to appear for the Reds amid speculation of a transfer. The Gunners had endured some difficult results at Anfield in recent seasons, and this would be no exception.
Gomez makes it in for Firmino! Liverpool have fizzed out of the blocks here today. Sadio Mane. Mane! Oh, wow! His signature goal. He's on fire. It's an absolute beauty.
More questionable defending from Arsenal and the devastating pace of Mohamed Salah produced a third for Liverpool, before Daniel Sturridge's header compounded an awful afternoon for Arsene Wenger.
Torment for Arsenal. That is how good Liverpool can be, how good Liverpool might be this season.
So Manchester United led the pack, taking maximum points without conceding a goal. Chelsea, meanwhile, had recovered following their disastrous opening day. Three teams were yet to register a point, while consecutive defeats for Arsenal saw them struggling near the bottom.
With the transfer window closed, September kicked off at the Etihad Stadium. Pep Guardiola's Manchester City hosted Liverpool. The Reds buoyed after retaining Philippe Coutinho and adding £35 million Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain.
Here's Aguero, round the goalkeeper. Aguero scores, as he always does when Liverpool visit. And here goes Mane and Edison. And the referee blows his whistle and appeals for calm. But there is concern for Edison on the floor here. It's a red card. Liverpool are down to 10. Mane is off.
A man down against Guardiola's lethal brand of possession football, Liverpool's day spiralled out of control. City fired another four goals past the Reds. The eventual 5-0 scoreline, a ruthless statement of intent from the home side.
Sané with no pressure on him at all. And that's what he can do. And Liverpool will head back to Merseyside with tails firmly between legs.
After securing the signings of Davinson Sanchez, Serge Aurier and Fernando Llorente, Tottenham enjoyed a 3-0 victory at Everton, Harry Kane scoring his first two goals of the season. With Alexis Sanchez still at the club despite interest from Manchester City, Arsenal recovered from consecutive defeats to overcome Bournemouth. A goal from Burnley summer signing Chris Wood condemned Crystal Palace to a 1-0 defeat. With the Eagles now the first team since 1924 to lose their four opening fixtures without scoring, Frank de Boer lost his job. replaced by former West Brom, Fulham and Liverpool boss Roy Hodgson. The pattern continued, though, and he suffered a 1-0 defeat to Southampton in his first match. Sergio Aguero notched a classy hat-trick as Manchester City dealt a 6-0 thrashing to Watford. An unhappy return to Old Trafford for Wayne Rooney saw Everton lose 4-0 to Manchester United. Romelu Lukaku scored against his old club, condemning Ronald Koeman to a third straight league defeat. Following news that Chelsea outcast Diego Costa would join Atletico Madrid in January, Alvaro Morata's hat-trick at Stoke suggested he could fill the void. And Liverpool gained a 3-2 victory over Leicester at the King Power Stadium. Jamie Vardy's missed penalty, leaving the Foxes with 4 defeats in 6 league matches. The final day of the month brought arguably its most eye-catching fixture. The champions Chelsea welcomed title favourites Manchester City.
Chelsea's chaotic start is a thing of the distant past. A month and a half since last they lost a football match. Manchester City, the decorative delight of our league. De Bruyne, oh, belter! Absolute belter from Kevin De Bruyne. There is no stopping that. Once a Chelsea blue, now giving Chelsea the blues. City have won it, deservedly so. And 3 points at the home of the champions for a clearly pumped Pep.
Little to choose at the top between the Manchester sides, while 10 points from a possible 12 in September saw both Spurs and Arsenal climb. Crystal Palace were setting unwanted records, 7 matches in and not a point or goal scored. Leicester's struggles continued as well.
As October arrived, Roy Hodgson's task at Crystal Palace looked to be getting harder by the week. Heavily beaten by the Manchester clubs in their previous 2 matches, Palace's next obstacle was a visit from Chelsea.
It's goodbye! Hold the back page! Crystal Palace have scored! It's been some time in coming. 731 minutes without a Premier League goal. And finally, they're off and running for the season.
Hodgson's joy was short-lived, Chelsea equalising through Timoe Bakayoko's first league goal for the club. But on his return from injury, Wilfried Zaha provided the attacking instinct sorely missed by the Eagles.
Sacco read the situation well. Zaha, still Zaha! They've done it again! No goals all season and then 2.5 against the champions. It's all over. They've scored and they've won. The worst start to a season in Premier League history ended, and how?
A scintillating attacking display sealed Manchester City's 9th straight win in all competitions. A 7-2 demolition of Stoke took their scoring tally to 24 goals in 5 league matches. Arsenal, unbeaten since their collapse at Liverpool, came unstuck against Watford. Tom Cleverley's late winner pushed Marco Silva's men into the top 4. 2 points behind Manchester City after a goalless draw at Anfield, Manchester United fell to a shock 2-1 defeat at Premier League newcomers Huddersfield. Goals from Aaron Moy and Laurent de Quatre sealed a historic win for the Terriers.
They've done it! For the first time in 65 years, Huddersfield have beaten Manchester United.
With just 1 victory in Leicester's first 8 league matches, Craig Shakespeare was dismissed by the Foxes, replaced by former Southampton boss Claude Puel. Sofiane Boufal's sublime solo goal decided an unremarkable contest between Southampton and West Brom. The winger's run and finish left the Baggies winless in 7 league games. A 5-2 defeat for Everton at home to Arsenal spelled the end for Ronald Koeman, his side in the relegation mix, and a sizeable transfer outlay yielding few positive results, the Dutchman's contract was terminated. It was 5 years since Tottenham's last league win over Liverpool. Mauricio Pochettino's men were unbeaten in 10 matches across all competitions, while back-to-back league draws had seen the Reds stall.
Trippier over the top for Kane, and Lovren let it go, and Harry Kane!
Liverpool were a mess. Lovren's missed another. And Kane's on his way, and Son's up inside of him. And Kane has found Son, and Tottenham are 2-0 on Wembley. Flying, just flying. Dejan Lovren wants the Wembley turf to eat him up. Klopp has nowhere to look.
Mohamed Salah's fifth league strike of the season looked to have given Liverpool a foothold, but two further goals from Spurs inflicted a painful 4-1 defeat on Jurgen Klopp's Reds.
Scintillating from Spurs, sobering for Liverpool. Tottenham beat the Reds for the first time in 5 years, and truthfully, they beat them hollow.
Manchester City's perfect October saw them take a 5-point lead at the top. The battle for the top four intensified, 4 points separating the teams from third to seventh. Crystal Palace's first points of the season offered the Eagles hope, while Everton slipped into the bottom three.
Nine wins, one draw, no defeats. Manchester City have made the best ever start to a Premier League season, and Pep Guardiola's men continued their imperious form with a 3-1 win over Arsenal. After City's win took them 8 points clear, Manchester United faltered away to Chelsea. Humiliated 4-0 at his old club last season, Jose Mourinho tasted defeat again, courtesy of Alvaro Morata's winner. Slaven Bilic's time at West Ham came to an end. A 4-1 defeat to Liverpool left the Hammers with just 9 points from 11 matches and nowhere for the Croatian to turn. Former Everton, Manchester United and Sunderland manager David Moyes was announced as his replacement. The enormity of the Scotsman's task was quickly made apparent with a 2-0 defeat by Watford in his first match. And Tony Pulis was dismissed from West Brom following a 4-0 thumping at home to Chelsea. Without a win in 10 league matches, Pulis said his goodbyes, with Gary Megson assuming temporary charge.
This is Arsenal's manner, and Tottenham are on it. Welcome, wherever you are, to this traditionally tumultuous territorial tussle in the north of the English capital. Tipped by Ozil, terrific header! Skodjan Mustafi breaks through for Arsenal! Derby day has ignition, and the light is an Arsenal light! Bellerin, Lacazette, Sanchez, two! Alexis Sanchez bursts into life for Arsenal, and there's clear North London sky between the Gunners and the Raiders from over the garden hedge. After 3.5 barren derby years, where's that power shift now?
With speculation linking Marco Silva and the managerial vacancy at Everton, Jesse Lingard's superb run and finish sealed Manchester United's 4-2 victory at Watford. Raheem Sterling's 96th-minute winner against Southampton sparked delirious scenes at the Etihad, Manchester City's 12th consecutive league victory. Mohamed Salah took his scoring tally to 12 goals in 14 matches, the Egyptian netting twice in Liverpool's 3-0 win at Stoke. With Sam Allardyce expected to agree an 18-month deal as Everton manager, Wayne Rooney sealed his first ever hat-trick for the Toffees in some style.
And Rooney from the halfway line, and Wayne Rooney has completed his hat-trick from inside his own half.
So Manchester City opened up an 8-point lead over their neighbours. Tottenham's two November defeats saw them drop to seventh place. Everton and Bournemouth moved out of the relegation zone, replaced by West Ham and Swansea. West Brom's slide down the table continued.
The start of winter saw Arsene Wenger lock horns with Jose Mourinho once again. Manchester United aimed to be the first visiting side to win a league match at Arsenal since January, and two goals within 11 minutes set Mourinho's men on their way. Alex Lacazette's eighth goal of the season dragged the Gunners back into the contest, but an inspired performance from David De Gea repeatedly thwarted the home side.
Paul Pogba for Manchester United. Around Koscielny, and Lingard finishes, and Manchester United have stolen back their two-goal lead. Manchester United came, saw, and plundered. Arsenal's home perfection finally punctured.
Manchester City came from behind to beat West Ham 2-1. David Silva clinched a 13th successive victory for City, equaling the record for most consecutive league wins in a season. Swansea fell to their sixth loss in seven matches, a defeat at Stoke keeping pressure on manager Paul Clement. Any optimism for Stoke, though, was quickly extinguished at Wembley. Spurs dispensed a 5-1 mauling, Mark Hughes' position as Potter's boss looking increasingly fragile. Alan Pardew was announced as Tony Pulis's replacement at West Brom. And Mohamed Salah produced another brilliant goal in the Merseyside derby, but a penalty from Wayne Rooney saw the game finish 1-1.
United, City divided, one football match in front of a billion pairs of eyes. Old Trafford, Manchester for the world.
8 points behind City, Manchester United couldn't afford to lose further ground. Victory for Guardiola's men would set a new record of 14 straight wins in a single top-flight season.
In his corner, 1-0 City! David Silva snatches it in front of the Stretford end! Otamendi missed it, Delph missed it, Rashford scored! From out of the blue for the red! Who plays it in? Lukaku clears badly and it's hooked home by Otamendi. Manchester United's mess is Manchester City's joy. Who catches City now? The Blues have ripped away from the Reds.
Marco Silva's promising start at Watford seemed a distant memory. The Hornets' 4-1 loss at home to Huddersfield, their fourth defeat in five matches. Everton's victory over Swansea was their third win in four league games under Sam Allardyce, but it was the end of the road for Swans boss Paul Clement, dismissed after 8 losses in 10 matches. And Manchester City's unstoppable form continued at home to Tottenham. The leaders fired 4 goals past Spurs, stretching their run to 16 straight league wins.
Arsenal-Liverpool, Liverpool-Arsenal. When did it last let you down? There's always a plot, there's always a narrative, there are generally goals.
Jurgen Klopp's side took a 2-goal lead at the Emirates, courtesy of a Philippe Coutinho header and Mohamed Salah's 15th league goal of the season. But after Alexis Sanchez snatched a lifeline, the Gunners turned the contest on its head.
Xhaka. Xhaka's had a hit, wow! He has blasted it in, and from nowhere! That's astonishing! It's Mesut Ozil who's nipped it over the goalkeeper! And Arsenal have 3 goals in next to no time!
Shell-shocked but not defeated, Liverpool forced an equaliser through Roberto Firmino, the Reds salvaging a point from a frenetic Friday night fixture. Harry Kane netted a hat-trick at Burnley to equal Alan Shearer's record for the most Premier League goals in a calendar year. After dropping 2 points at Leicester, Manchester United needed Jesse Lingard's equaliser to salvage a draw at home to Burnley, another stumble in Mourinho's ailing pursuit of the title. Chelsea capped off an impressive festive run with a 5-0 win over Stoke, another damaging blow to Mark Hughes. Carlos Carvalhal was announced as manager of Swansea City. The Portuguese had an immediate impact with a comeback win at Watford. And Manchester City's invincibility looked under serious threat away to Crystal Palace. Edison saved a stoppage-time penalty to secure a 0-0 draw and maintain their unbeaten record. 2017, an astonishing 12 months for Harry Kane. With 36 league goals in the calendar year, the 37th against Southampton at Wembley would see him set a new record.
Wembley hushed. Eriksen. Kane! The perfect year! 37.
Alan Shearer's calendar year record was history, a remarkable achievement from Kane. The striker completed a hat-trick to finish 2017 with an incredible 39 league strikes.
How good is he? What will history write of Harry Kane?
Just past the halfway mark and City's 14-point lead already seemed insurmountable. Meanwhile, Burnley's strong start to the season saw them in seventh. Swansea finished 2017 bottom on goal difference, while West Ham hovered in the relegation zone. Just 4 points separated 13th from 20th.
With the January transfer window officially open, Alexis Sanchez's future at Arsenal remained uncertain. The Gunners began the new year with a blockbuster meeting against London rivals Chelsea. After taking the lead through Jack Wilshere, Arsenal needed Hector Bellerin's late equaliser to salvage a 2-2 draw with Antonio Conte's Blues. Tottenham's 1-1 draw with West Ham included two stunning goals. Pedro Obiang's thunderous effort, almost matched by Son Heung-min's long-range drive. Having confirmed a £75 million signing of Southampton's Virgil van Dijk in a world-record deal for a defender, Liverpool registered a 2-1 win at Burnley. However, Philippe Coutinho's absence through injury did little to dampen speculation of an imminent transfer. Stoke's 1-0 loss to Newcastle proved to be Mark Hughes' final league match in charge. A fifth defeat in seven games spelled the end for the Welshman. Two wins and a draw from January's opening fortnight lifted West Ham away from the relegation zone. A Lanzini-Arnautović masterclass inspired a 4-1 win at Huddersfield. And Arsenal suffered a first-ever defeat to Bournemouth, the Cherries' 2-1 victory representing just their second win in 11 league matches. With Philippe Coutinho's departure to Barcelona completed in a £142 million deal, Liverpool faced a huge test.
Liverpool distant chasers, Manchester City runaway leaders, but both purveyors of football the way the world loves to see it played. And perhaps the City players consider this the greatest threat to their invincibility.
Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain's vicious strike fired Liverpool into a ninth-minute lead before Leroy Sané's seventh league goal of the season restored parity. However, in nine second-half minutes, the leaders were torn apart.
Firmino away from Stones! Scores with sublime skill! Salah again. And he's kept the ball, and he's found Mane. Sadio Mane has thundered it in! What a high for Anfield! Look at it bounce, and Manchester City have a big problem now. Out comes Ederson. Salah! What about it? The Fab Three all on the score sheet. And fabulously, fabulously on each occasion.
The side that had dropped just 4 points all season rallied with goals from Bernardo Silva and Ilkay Gundogan. But Liverpool held on to end City's remarkable unbeaten run.
Manchester City lose. That might be your headline, but there are so many more. That was some game.
The Premier League paid tribute to Cyril Regis following his death aged 59. A hugely respected figure, the former West Brom, Coventry and Aston Villa striker had been a pioneer for black footballers. Defeated but not derailed, Manchester City bounced back from their loss at Anfield with a convincing 3-1 win over Newcastle. Liverpool, meanwhile, followed their rousing victory over the leaders with a meek 1-0 defeat away to bottom side Swansea. Carlos Carvalhal's galvanising effect on the Swans continued with a 3-1 win at home to Arsenal. An eventful period had seen the Gunners swap Alexis Sanchez for Manchester United's Henrik Mkhitaryan, but their inconsistency remained. Paul Lambert was announced as Mark Hughes' replacement, and the Scotsman made a winning start. Stoke's 2-0 victory left Huddersfield winless in six. Watford dismissed Marco Silva after an eighth loss in 11 league matches. Questioning Silva's commitment since Everton's attempt to poach him in November, the Hornets quickly announced Javi Gracia as his replacement. Everton added Theo Walcott and Cenk Tosun to their ranks. Walcott's two goals against Leicester quickly endearing him to the club's fans. Chelsea confirmed the signings of Emerson, Olivier Giroud and Ross Barkley. Antonio Conte's men hadn't lost in the league since early December, but collapsed to a shocking 3-0 defeat at home to Bournemouth. Alexis Sanchez's first league match in a Manchester United shirt saw Jose Mourinho's side lose 2-0 at Spurs. Christian Eriksen's strike just 11 seconds after kickoff stunned United. Phil Jones's calamitous own goal confirmed victory for Tottenham. United dropped 15 points behind City. Just 2 points separated Liverpool, Chelsea and Spurs, while Arsenal slipped to sixth. An unbeaten month lifted West Ham away from danger, but winless runs for Huddersfield and Southampton dragged them into trouble.
Tottenham's trip to Liverpool saw the league's two most prolific scorers go head-to-head. At kick-off, Mohamed Salah's haul of 19 league goals was second only to Harry Kane's 21. The Egyptian drew first blood, snatching a 1-0 lead that Liverpool retained until the 80th minute.
Decisive from Karius, there's Wanyama! Oh! A rocket shot into the Kop End net! Took it in his stride and just blasted it!
With full-time approaching, a penalty offered Harry Kane the chance of netting his 100th Premier League goal, an opportunity he wasted. Liverpool looked to have won the match minutes later, Mohamed Salah's 21st league goal of the season surely confirming victory for Jurgen Klopp. But following Virgil van Dijk's challenge on Eric Lamella, Kane made amends from the penalty spot.
And this time, Kane is up to the task! Century of Premier League goals and a valuable point for Tottenham at Anfield in the most dramatic of finishes.
Arsenal had secured the signing of £56 million striker Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang, the forward quickly finding his feet with a debut goal against Everton. Manchester City signed defender Aymeric Laporte for a club record £57.2 million. Sergio Aguero's four goals in a 5-1 thrashing of Leicester took the Argentinian to 21 league strikes for the season. Manchester United, meanwhile, fell 16 points behind City with a shock 1-0 defeat at Newcastle. Matt Ritchie's goal secured a first win in five for the Magpies. And following their 3-0 loss at home to Bournemouth, Chelsea were beaten 4-1 at Watford, the Hornets netting three late goals to deepen Antonio Conte's misery. Champions for a combined 18 seasons in the Premier League era, but neither Manchester United nor Chelsea could live with Manchester City's formidable form. The Blues travelled to Old Trafford looking to avoid a third defeat in four league matches. Willian's ferocious strike gave the visitors the lead, but former Chelsea striker Romelu Lukaku inspired a United comeback. The Belgian netted his 13th league goal of the season to level the match, before then setting up the winner.
Lukaku.
Lingard! Off the bench, onto the score sheet!
Victory for Jose Mourinho against his former employers, but another defeat piled the pressure on Antonio Conte. Manchester City retained their advantage at the top, a meeting with Arsenal in the EFL Cup final leaving both sides with a game in hand. Chelsea's poor February saw them drop out of the top four. A tight affair, just 5 points separated 11th to 18th. Stoke City dropped back into the bottom three, West Brom in danger of being cut adrift.
After consecutive league defeats and cup final disappointment, Arsenal suffered a further setback with a 2-1 loss at Brighton, the Gunners dropping 13 points behind fourth-place Spurs. Having won the EFL Cup, Manchester City's title march continued with a 1-0 win over Chelsea. A 3-0 loss at home to Burnley was West Ham's third defeat in a row. The match punctuated by protests from some supporters, with a relegation scrap now looming for the Hammers. Maurizio Pellegrino's time as Southampton boss came to an end following defeat at Newcastle. The Argentinian dismissed after a sequence of one win in 17 league games. The 200th meeting of Manchester United and Liverpool saw the sides separated by just 2 points in second and third place. United hadn't lost a league match against their rivals since 2014, a sequence that looked like being extended thanks to Marcus Rashford.
Oh, here's Rashford. He's onside, away from Alexander-Arnold. Rashford lashes it in! A flash of a finish! A rash flash!
Two goals within 25 minutes from Rashford took the match away from Jurgen Klopp's side. Despite a second-half own goal from Eric Bailly, United held on for a 2-1 victory.
Mourinho over Klopp, Manchester over Liverpool, and United have a 5-point advantage over their most hostile neighbours.
Mohamed Salah bounced back from a quiet performance at Old Trafford in emphatic fashion. The winger helped himself to 4 goals in Liverpool's 5-0 mauling of Watford, taking his tally to 36 in 41 games across all competitions. Mark Hughes was appointed as Maurizio Pellegrino's successor at Southampton. Sacked as Stoke boss in January, Hughes' return to the league began with a 3-0 setback at West Ham. West Brom's slide towards relegation continued with an 8th straight defeat. With just a single victory from 18 league matches in charge, Alan Pardew and the club parted ways. A 5th straight league win took Manchester City to the brink of Premier League glory. 3 goals in a first-half blitz saw them crush Everton. Pep Guardiola's men could now win the title against Manchester United in their next fixture. Mohamed Salah's late winner at Crystal Palace strengthened Liverpool's grip on a top four spot. The Reds 10 points clear of fifth place Chelsea. As they tighten their hold on third position, Chelsea and Tottenham squared off in a potentially decisive fixture in terms of Champions League qualification. Spurs had never won a Premier League match at Stamford Bridge, and Alvaro Morata's header suggested the wait would go on. However, a thunderous effort from Christian Eriksen levelled things before a double from Dele turned the contest.
Here's Dele Alli through the middle, onside and scoring! With glorious deftness of touch! Dele Alli, 3-1 Spurs at the bridge! End of an era, maybe, start of another! Spurs win at Chelsea. And right now, nothing else matters.
Manchester City were now within touching distance of a title destined to be theirs from the word go. Chelsea slipped 8 points off the top four pace. Southampton dropped into the bottom three, and another month without a win or draw saw West Brom 10 points from safety.
A sad start to April saw the passing of former England captain and Chelsea coach Ray Wilkins, aged 61. Every Premier League ground paid their respects with a minute of applause. Manchester City had a once-in-a-generation opportunity to seal the title against their greatest rivals, Manchester United. A victory at the Etihad would see City crowned champions. A dream start saw Vincent Kompany and Ilkay Gundogan put Pep Guardiola's side 2-0 up within half an hour. But a goal from Paul Pogba inspired a breathtaking turnaround.
United have a say in it again. Sanchez, Pogba, 2-2! In a flash, the scene has changed! Shades of red on this blue-blue day! It ain't done yet! Sanchez rips it in, Smalling! United 2-0 down, 3-2 up on hostile territory! City, who've not lost here all season, trail to the enemy. United rule the city, so City for now do not yet rule the land. Jose's Reds have delayed the blue parade.
Crystal Palace registered a crucial 3-2 win over rivals Brighton and Hove Albion. Two goals from Wilfred Zaha lifting the Eagles away from the drop zone. After a 3-2 defeat by Arsenal, Southampton suffered further heartache at home to Chelsea. Saints let a two-goal lead slip to lose against the Blues, the threat of relegation looming large for Mark Hughes. And Newcastle achieved a fourth straight league win by downing Arsenal 2-1 at St James's Park. Defeated by Manchester United and knocked out of the Champions League by Liverpool, Pep Guardiola had endured his toughest week of the season. But victory at Spurs would take Manchester City to the brink of Premier League glory ahead of United's meeting with West Brom the following day.
Onside away from Sanchez, Jesus scores and City lead at Wembley. And Manchester City have their pick-me-up.
Ilkay Gundogan doubled City's lead from the penalty spot. Christian Eriksen pulled a goal back for Tottenham, but Raheem Sterling confirmed a 3-1 victory.
So much for crisis. Little evidence of that. Now, come what may, City are one win away.
So City required three more points to secure the title, assuming Manchester United avoided defeat against West Brom the next day. The Baggies, now under the caretaker charge of Darren Moore, were seemingly doomed to relegation.
Front with depth, Dawson round the back, and snatched in by Jay Rodriguez! It's a goal which may win a title! It's a goal which has stunned and silenced Old Trafford! It is an unthinkable goal, and right now, you can't tell the bottom from the top. Manchester City are champions. The most contrary coronation, crowned crazily in their absence at Old Trafford by the bottom club in the league.
Mohamed Salah struck his 31st league goal of the campaign to equal the all-time record for a 38-game Premier League season. But the Reds let a two-goal advantage slip to draw at a resurgent West Brom. Chelsea refused to give up on a top-four finish, a 2-1 victory at Burnley handing Antonio Conte back-to-back wins. After 22 years, Arsene Wenger announced he'd leave Arsenal at the end of the season. A guard of honour greeted newly confirmed champions Manchester City at the Etihad. Pep Guardiola's record-chasing side inflicted a 5-0 thrashing on relegation-threatened Swansea. Mohamed Salah's astonishing campaign saw him crowned PFA Player of the Year, claiming English football's most coveted individual accolade. On Arsene Wenger's final trip to Old Trafford, the Frenchman received a warm tribute from old foes Sir Alex Ferguson and Jose Mourinho. Paul Pogba's opener was cancelled out by former United man Henrik Mkhitaryan. But Wenger's hopes for a victorious sign-off in Manchester were extinguished in stoppage time. Manchester City confirmed as champions with a record equaling five games to spare. Chelsea kept their chances of a top four finish alive. Burnley needed just one point to guarantee a Europa League spot. The battle for survival remained open following defeats for West Ham, Huddersfield and Swansea. Stoke knew a loss in their next match would see them relegated. West Brom's great escape was heavily dependent on other results.
After 22 years and 10 major trophies, Arsene Wenger emerged at the Emirates for his final home match as Arsenal manager. The Frenchman was afforded a glorious send-off, the Gunners putting five past Burnley on an emotional day in North London.
Bellerin's cross! Aubameyang scores again! What a way to say goodbye! Fittingly, goals galore at the end of an era, the Arsene Wenger era.
Thank you all very well for having me for such a long time. Above all, I am like you, I'm an Arsenal fan. I will miss you. Thank you all for being such an important part of my life and hope to see you soon. Well done. Bye-bye.
After a season of non-stop goal scoring, Manchester City's coronation coincided with a 0-0 draw at home to Huddersfield. A crucial point for David Wagner's side as City laid their hands on the Premier League trophy. West Brom's 1-0 win over Spurs continued their turnaround, but the Baggies' destiny was still out of their own hands. At Stamford Bridge, Chelsea overcame Liverpool 1-0 to tighten up the race for the Champions League. West Ham looked like surviving. A victory at Leicester took the Hammers to 38 points. And Brighton cemented their place in the top flight with a 1-0 victory over Manchester United. The footballing world was shaken by news that former United manager Sir Alex Ferguson had suffered a brain hemorrhage. Stoke became the first club to be relegated. A 2-1 home defeat to Crystal Palace assured the Eagles of survival, but sealed the Potter's fate and led to the eventual departure of Paul Lambert. Southampton then faced Swansea in a relegation showdown at the Liberty Stadium.
Romeo, Austin, and Gabby Adidi! How do you put a price on that goal? Is that the knockout blow for Swansea City? A huge victory for the Saints, who march on towards safety.
The result confirmed West Brom's relegation and gave Southampton a three-point lead and vastly superior goal difference over Swansea with one game remaining. The Swans were dependent on a slip-up from Huddersfield. The Terriers travelled to Chelsea the following day, knowing a point would confirm their safety and all but condemn Swansea to the drop.
Moy clipping it forward, and De Poitra will chase. Now Caballero, it's De Poitra. It is 1-0 to Huddersfield. Is that the goal that keeps them in the Premier League?
With Tottenham playing Newcastle on the same evening, anything less than a win for Chelsea could severely dent their top four hopes. Marcus Alonso's freak goal levelled the match, but a heroic Huddersfield held on.
Mission impossible achieved. Huddersfield Town retain their Premier League status. Chelsea's Champions League hopes are in tatters. Huddersfield will party long into the night.
As Chelsea stumbled, Tottenham clinched a top four finish at Wembley.
Son. Oh, it's there! Harry Kane! A precious, precious goal for Spurs! There's the full-time whistle. They've done enough. Tottenham have got the victory and a Champions League football once again next season.
Arsene Wenger enjoyed a 1-0 win at Huddersfield in his final match, the Frenchman's two decades with the Gunners ending on a high. Tottenham's 5-4 thriller with Leicester saw Harry Kane finish the season on 30 league goals, not quite enough to overhaul Mohamed Salah. Swansea's relegation from the league was mathematically confirmed with a 2-1 defeat on the final day, Carlos Carvalhal's last match in charge. A morale-sapping 3-0 defeat at Newcastle saw Chelsea's top four hopes disintegrate. Antonio Conte's side had the consolation of going on to win the FA Cup. A momentous final day for Mohamed Salah and Manchester City. On 31 league goals, Salah was aiming for the Golden Boot and a new Premier League scoring record. City had already set record totals of 97 points and 105 goals scored. Now they could become the first side ever to reach 100 Premier League points by beating Southampton. As the season drew to a close, history beckoned.
Dominic Solanke. Mo Salah! It's a new record. The most goals ever in a 38-game Premier League season. 32 and counting.
The Egyptian had done it. A 4-0 win for Liverpool confirmed their top four finish ahead of a Champions League final with Real Madrid. Meanwhile, on the south coast, City sealed immortality in the 94th minute.
Forward by De Bruyne. Gabriel Jesus! Wins it with the last kick of the season!
Manchester City finished 19 points above Manchester United. Tottenham and Liverpool both secured Champions League football and Burnley a Europa League spot. Despite finishing eighth, Everton dismissed Sam Allardyce. Even though West Ham retained their Premier League status, David Moyes left the club, replaced by former Manchester City title-winning manager Manuel Pellegrini. Swansea, Stoke and West Bromwich Albion were relegated.
Pep Guardiola, universally revered throughout the global game. Immaculate, always prepared.
Manchester City's football is sparkling. Another mind-blowing performance.
Wow! Sensational, scintillating, attacking football.
We are watching something special. We are in the presence of greatness.
The runaway champions of 2018 are Manchester City.
Hi there, I'm Rebecca Lowe, studio host for NBC's coverage of the Premier League. Don't forget to hit subscribe to watch highlights all season long and tune in for Premier League mornings every weekend at 7 a.m. Eastern on NBCSN. And for more than 1,400 hours of exclusive Premier League content, make sure to visit nbcsports.com/gold.